Do subscribe to Ikigai channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
These two gentlemen, that was Avery McLeod and McCarty, when they did this experiment, their experiment were very similar to that the Griffith's experiment of mouse. Now, the only difference between them and Griffith was that Griffith introduced his bacterial strains into live mouse and saw the results. Whereas these people, what they did was they took the bacterial strains and transferred into test tubes and studied the results. For this, they took two different bacterial strains. One strain was the rough strain that was non-capsulated and which cannot cause any disease. The strains used were from Pneumococcus bacteria, and another strain of Pneumococcus bacteria was capsulated, which was termed as the smooth strain, which could cause disease. So basically there were two strains, the S strain, which was pathogenic, and the R strain, which was non-pathogenic. What they did was they killed the S strain or the pathogenic strain and added it into five different set of test tubes. Along with that, they also added the rough strain, that is non-capsulated and non-pathogenic strain, into all these five different test tubes. With that, they added nutrient broth, serum medias, and carbohydrates, protein, enzyme, and DNA. And one was the control test tube. Now, every other material, which was whether it was carbohydrate, proteins, enzymes, were added along with its substrate and the reaction molecule, or you can say the enzyme. So obviously, the component would be broken down into its constituent elements. What Avery and McCarty observed was that in a test tube in which DNSA was added, they could observe certain results, which concluded that DNA was the genetic material. Let's try and find out what it was about. What Avery, McLeod and McCarty did was they had added an S strain, which was the pathogenic strain and which was capsulated, with a heat kill strain, that was the R strain, which was the smooth strain. And this strain, the R strain, was non-pathogenic, also non-disease causing, in set of five test tubes along with nutrient broth and serum in that. Now, various substances were isolated, like carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, enzymes, which were present in nutrient broth, from the S type of bacteria. Now, each substance that were added to the separate nutrient medium contained a non-pathogenic R type of cell, as we can call as the non-virulent type of strain. In the fourth test tube or fourth set, in the presence of DNA, some R cells were transformed into S cell, that is, the non-virulent strain was transferred into the virulent state. However, in the fifth set, when DNase enzyme, or you can say DNA hydrolyzing enzyme, that is the enzyme that breaks down DNA, was added, transformation did not take place. So student, what we can say is, in every other test tube, transformation could be seen when that particular substance, whether it was carbohydrates, proteins, enzymes were broken down, transformation could be seen. Whereas in the fourth test tube, transformation did not take place. So from this, they concluded that DNA was the transforming material. It was the DNA that is transferred from one species of capsulated bacteria to another species which was non-virulent. It was the DNA, the genetic material, that was transported, or you can say transferred, from the smooth strain which was capsulated, virulent, disease causing, to the rough strain which was non-virulent and non-capsulated and can cause disease. This experiment also showed that process of transformation takes place, and DNA was the leading cause, or you can say the genetic material. Students, I hope you all are clear with this concept and about this experiment. Thank you.